No, really, no problem. This swap. Here we go. This is our sixth attempt at this mission, and like again, we are trying to get the five fortune here. This is solo scenario for the uprising, and so that's what we're working on right now. Let me see if I can actually get this one to come to. Yeah, let's do this quick. I'm gonna do one thing really quick, guys. Whoa. Let me get this thing set up so that we can kind of see a little better. Yeah, make sure that's exactly what I want. Yep. Perfect. Let's update this quick. Give me one sec, guys. There we go. That's a little better now. Now if I look at rules or anything, we can just look here. So while we're playing, if there are any questions that come up, we can just look at it together. But okay. Alright, so there we go. So like I said, it's the next attempt. We're going to try to get this thing done here. So okay, so wave one, this is the Horizon Wrath level first scenario. This is literally my sixth attempt at this. We're trying to get three renown also. That's kind of where we're stuck at. So setup's the same. We had to flip this token to here. Other than that, 1, 2, 3, 4. Other than that, everything is pretty much set up to standard form. So we can just start right from here. Okay, so first things first is we're gonna roll the event dice though for wave one. Here we go. That's a 6. And the 6 is, I'm pretty sure Keem gets +1 range. Add a range upgrade to Keem, ignoring her upgrade restrictions. Okay. It's gonna be a little tougher for us now to figure out, but that's fine. Okay, and now we'll go to the prep phase. Ingot phase, skip, mark phase, skip, and next phase, the build phase, we can upgrade it. So we put an upgrade on any tower, I might as well put an upgrade on this tower right here. Go to range. Okay. Attempt number 6. Yeah, man, Mark, it legit is the 6th attempt, man. I don't know what I'm not doing right. I mean, this is also my first time playing the Horizons Wrath. I sat down technically last night and today. But yeah, man, it's literally just over and over and over just trying to understand what's going on here. I must be missing something about the faction, but I'm slowly learning as I'm going. Yeah, I mean, because normally, like, solo scenario is a lot easier when you come back to it after you do a bunch of competitive plays, because then you understand factions and units well. Yeah, I don't really understand the units tool right now, so I'm kind of, like, trying to still learn it and figure out. But you know, Mark, you know what I mean. So okay, Event dice, he get the plus one range. This tower has 10 health. So, that 10. So if you guys want to know which health that thing has, I put it here. So we all know this thing's got 10 health on their base. Okay. Prep phase, they're going to get Harris, an upgraded, promoted Harrier, and a Joust, but not promoted. So far, Mark, our strategy is to capture the Harriers. And I'm going to try that right now, because last game I played, I realized that the Corsari can capture. I was like, well, that might be really nice. That might work for my advantage. But other than that, I have 2 hours before work if you want to practice competitive play. Ooh, man, you're definitely tempting me, dude, so bad. Damn, because I already have the scenario set up, man. If I didn't have it set up, I would definitely say yes. Just the thing set up. And it took me like 40 minutes to set it up. Damn, Mark. If this wasn't set up, I'd say yes for sure, man. But it's already set up, so I'm just going to roll with this one. Just get this bad boy with, man. But dude, next one for sure. Okay, so what are we doing with our heroes? So we got 5 command points. Asari's Corsari. Or should I get the gunnery? I want the Corsari, because then I can upgrade them. What's the 5-4? And we'll put a Swabby right on top. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So we'll have that. Okay, and the heirs go first this turn, so. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. What? 1, 2, 3, 4. Oops. It's gonna move too far. And then 1, 2. Okay. Corsari is Corsair. Yeah, thanks, Mark. Yeah, man, you can definitely tell how my reading there pretty good, right? Okay, next is Ars. Here we go. Our Swabby hero. We'll still send this 1, 2, 3, and then when Swabby's this, Mistbane. Is that way? Okay, then. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. He's gonna quick strike here. Spire's gonna fire. I am going to have this fire the guy in the back. So here we go. 2 damage. Okay. Kills the guy in the back. Giving us 1 source. And now this fire is gonna fire for 1 damage here. Let's see what we got. 1 damage. Oops, and this guy's supposed to go 1, 2 here. Okay, now it's back to us. Go here, and then go 1, 2. Spire's fire, exploration, move phase done for us. Then it's their turn, so quick, he's gonna go 1, 2. He will kick strike and kill my Swabby. And he will just get removed from the game. But this guy will come out promoted with 5 health. I think that's the way to go, man. I think capturing that might be the strategy. Okay. And this guy's gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, and he will attack my tower. The chips are backwards there. Okay. Spire's fire. 2 attack dice into 1 attack dice. Hold on. We gotta go back. We already messed up. We already made a mistake. Let me go back. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here. We're gonna back up a little bit, because I made a small mistake. Let me show you. So, 1, 2. Yep, made a small mistake. Okay, I made a small mistake, and I'm just going to restart this whole setup here, which is, well, I think I'm going to restart, I'll just put that there, here we go. For some reason, I thought my tower had one extra attack dice, so we're just going to, I'm just going to quickly reset this, which should be too much, so. But at least that's simple. Okay, so, they went, we go, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, they go, 1, 2, 3, 4, quick strike, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, towers fire, yep, so this tower is going to attack into there. One attack dice. Here we go. No damage. Okay. And then the other tower is also going to attack the guy in the back. One damage. Okay. So now it is our turn. So 1, 2. One, two, as far as fire, exploration. So then it goes back to the enemies. Okay, 1, 2, 3. He will quick strike the Swabby, killing it. I can't afford to heal it, but Corsana comes out, the Corsair comes out with 5 health. This is gonna go 1, 2, 3. He's going to quick strike my tower, removing the range. Okay. If you guys can see that down there a little bit better, here we go. This might be a little better. A lot of towers here. And then, the joust is going to go 1, 2. Spire's fire. This fire is going to attack in the harrier in the front. Blank. This one's going to attack the harrier in the front also. Killing it. Okay, do you want us 1 experience points? Now it's our turn. Corsair is going to come up one, and Spire's fire is going to attack, so kill the Harrier, capturing it. So, good for us, and that's 1 experience point, up to 2. Then this guy's going to go 1, 2, he will destroy our tower. Quick strike, tower's fire, so 1 attack dice into him. 1 damage. Okay. You guys following along, and I'm going a little faster than normal because I've done this 6 times, so I mean, the repeat on level 1 is it's the same. Then it's our turn. 1, 2. 1, 2. Sparse fires, and we attack, so we're going to attack this guy, killing it, and we're going to capture this joust. That's going to give us 2 source. Up to 4. Their turn back to, before I do that, I'm going to explore. Toxic CBS. I do not have to reveal it. So what we got here is, what do we got here? Well, toxic CBS. Cibicia. Do I want to reveal it? I don't think I do. The reason I don't is I don't want to get hit. It's going to be 1 damage, 2, 3 damage. I'll keep it down for now. Okay, so then he's going to attack it, killing it. capturing it, giving us a two source, which brings up to four. Their turn, back to us. One, two. One, two. Spire's fire. Exploration. That's when he retaliates, that's right. Riposte. 100% sure how you say that, but that's fine. So he's gonna die most likely the way he forgets the tower, so we might as well reveal. 6 health on there. Okay. That is 2 damage. It retaliates for 2. And then we are going to... was I going to explore that? Yes, I'm going to explore this. And then I am going to capture this here. So now it's the enemy's movement phase. They're doing nothing. Back to us. Repost. Thank you, Mark. So now it's back to us. 1, 2. Do I won't leave my hero there? Yep, and Spire's fire. Exploration. The Waken Stone. I am going to flip that. And engage. Again, another engage back there. Okay. So we do have the Altar of Aggression here. Awaken is removed. And he will attack this game one more. Next is their turn. So Keen will fire 2 on here. I'm not sure what I want to do here, because if I don't know if I want to kill Sibisia or not, because this creature bug thing, what the hell ever it is gonna do so much work. She'll do 2 damage, which is gonna kill the Harriers before they even get here. So but no, I will just honestly just stay there with my hero. So as far as fire, 2 attack dice. Awaken has been removed. 1 damage, killing Corsair. And that is it for wave 1. So wave 1 is done. We roll the event dice. Let's see what we got happening here. There's a 2. Increase the your cannibal die by 1, and increase the air's fortress gate by 1. Okay, so that's how much health we have right now. Now, oh, Mark, I got a question for you, man. While you're here, okay, here's the question. I read the ruling on the reference sheet, can't explain it, but I want to be 100% sure. So it has to do with these Earthscapes here. So it says you can build an Earthscape as long as the adjacent isle has influence. So just for scenario's sake, could I build a tower here? But I don't have any influence on here, so I'm guessing no. So I guess they could have been on the hill. The reason why I'm asking is because of the Shadow Strike, where you can do translocate Because it says you can translocate an adjacent air's spire. Adjacent spire. Because I've put the shadow. Think about putting the shadow one here. But I couldn't translocate this tower here. Hex group, yeah. And I think you're right too, because that's what it pretty much said there too. Okay, so wave two, we did that. We can put an upgrade on any tower. We're going to put an attack upgrade. But yeah, currently you cannot, yeah. Okay, and we are have four source, so let's get the... We did have one of our Swabbies die, so that shouldn't be in there. Four source, what do you do? At the start of your turn, also face each gunship you may attack. At the start of your turn, during... Each of your gunships, gunboats, spires may attack. In a, each of your gunboat spires may attack an opposing faction union. Gun, at the start of your turn during onslaught phase, each of your gunboat spires. And gunboat spires, I'm guessing, are the ones that, yep, have a directional aim. If you have launch pad level 1, you can put the Shadow Rift there and then relocate. Well, that's my thing. Yeah, yeah. With launch pad. Launch bay level 1. Well, that's a thing. The launch bay level 1, it says you can we can put it there. But the problem is for relocate, and here's my problem. For relocate, it says this. As a limited build option, you may swap this spire position with another Horizon Wrath spire on this aisle or an adjacent one. But I don't have an adjacent. I don't have... I guess I'd build a tower here then to swap it. You may then change the direction and swap spire arrows. Your launch pad, you can put a shadow skiff there and then relocate. Yeah. And that's what I was trying to do. I guess I need to put a tower there. And that's kind of where I was heading. Starter's mark faces, put these two source. Well, I got a Harry out and a Joust out, so I'm pretty happy with that. Now we've got to get, the next setup out. Okay, so I'm gonna spend 3 source, bring it down to 1, and I'm gonna lock that. The launch bay level 1, which allows me to build upgraded ships. And these shouldn't be here. That shouldn't be there. So shadow skiffs and lifeboat spires. Pretty much launched by level 1 is shadow skiffs and light lifeboat spires can now be constructed. That's what that is there. Okay, and now we'll go to the so 2 Harriers, Joust, and the Joust. 2 Harriers. Into jousts, and these jousts are the promoted ones, and I have one of them, so that's pretty nice. That's like a super nice one. Grab that joust early on. I think that might be a good go-to. There. All right, so now we are going to, what are we doing for 7 command points? Is capture optional or mandatory? Let me see if that's mandatory or optional. Capture. efficient defeats an opposing unit minion, you may place that minion before beside your barracks when this minion controls faction. Yep. Okay, so you may. It's not forced to. But I do need a range guy with 7 command points. I do need gunnery out. This thing. I mean, I guess it does transport. I didn't even think about that. Oh my gosh. Well, that's a level up one. Five, six, seven there. Okay. We'll bring the two swabbies out too. We'll bring the two swabbies also. I guess I can transport that thing, slower unit on top. So yeah, I guess I could transport the glider. I didn't think about that at all. I mean, I could group it technically. Let's try that. So that's going to be our strategy there. I'm going to have a corset in front and then a glider in the back, which is going to just spring out and bounce. Okay, and the first one to go is going to be us this time. Okay, so 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, I'll keep my hero right there. Then this will be them. One, two, three, four. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so that was them. Now it's back to me. 1, 2. 1, 2. Back to them. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the light. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. So now they're going to quick strike for 2 here. And retaliate. Oh, it's not going to retaliate. Okay. He's going to quick strike for 2. Then retaliate for 2. And the Harrier will kill it. That's going to give them 1 tower, and by that they get nothing, which is super nice for us, thank goodness. Our turn, 1, 2, 1, 2. Oh, wait, before we do that, Spire is fire, so this one is going to attack the Harrier in the back. 3 damage, killing it. Giving us 1 source, which brings us up to 2. Okay, and then now we go. So 1, 2, 1, 2. As far as fire's attack base, I'm not attacking. Actually, we are going to attack. He's a hit for 1 there. And it does not retaliate. Then it's the enemy's turn, he's gonna go 1, he's gonna die. There's toxic secretion, give me 1 source. Then go 1, 2, 3, he's gonna die. What? I don't get 1 source from him dying. What am I doing? He's gonna die. From that fury kick, from the toxic secretion. Yeah, I seen the Spire's mark. I fixed that, man. I noticed that. I was like, ooh, wait a minute. Now it's. Oh, man. Now, this is a strange question. If he dies while he's walking. So I guess he'll just come here and die instantly. Because toxicretion. Okay. which will allow me to promote a unit. So I'm going to promote this Swabby here. Emboldened. Let's see what that does. If this unit is a defeated wall group, the newly revealed unit may immediately move and attack. This does not count as a newly revealed unit's movement or attack for the turn. Oh shit, it loses range though. We'll just upgrade this guy. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep, there we go. You don't have the source. You don't get source of dive. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, I took that away. But I will spend a 2 source to get this, to keep the Swabby alive. This is the issue of the delay, lol. I wonder if I can make the delay even slower, Mark, but maybe we'll find, maybe there's a way to fix the delay. At least I'm always checking. But yeah. Kinda try to be on top of those things a little more. And then it'll go to the attack. Oh, this guy moves here. Now go to attack phase, and my hero is going to kill it, giving us 4 source. He produces up to 4. And he gets a promotion. It's their turn, now it's back to us. So here's a really the question now, Mark, is if, let's say I put a rigging one here, right? Let's say I put a tower here for 1. Could I then build a tower here? Do I then have the influence to build a tower on this hex? Or do I have to literally build one here and build one here then? Yeah, there's a delay, so I'm a patient man. If I build this tower here, can I throw a tower here right away? That was my, okay, yeah, no. That's what I was thinking too. Damn. Well, I'm going to spend 1 source, and I'm going to put this tower here either way. Then I'm going to spend, three source. Or do I not spend a 3 source? That's a good question. No, the second option. Yeah. When constructing Shadow Rifts or both, add plus 1 fortification dice. See, I don't want to do that. So before I move, there's 1 limited build option there. But do I want to build the showers? Not yet, I'll pass. Okay, so. You know what? I'm gonna spend 1 source and I'm gonna build another rig. Another one there. That's my second build option. And then, so that's my 2 build options. There, we're done. Okay. And time to move my units. So first off is, I'm going to send my hero back to base, which gives us 2 points. Second thing is we're going to go 1, 2. This tower does get removed for that. Rigging, if I'm correct. Rigging. Horizon Rats heroes may move. Move to the spire as if it were a path hex. Doing so immediately returns the hero to your fortress and returns the spire to your barracks. Nice. Okay, then it is that guy moves for 2. This guy moves for 2. Their turn. It's back to us. So if he has a range of 2, I mean, he has range 1, range 2, so he's only attacking this far out. Gotcha. Okay. So if he doesn't attack me, towers on fire at me. Why is this guy behind? So wait, one, two. There we go. Back to them, back to me. One, two. One, two. Spire will fire at this one here because he can kill that. Two damage killing my Swabby. We'll spend the two stores and save it. We'll promote this guy, which I don't think that does much for us, honestly. Flying, breakthrough, transport, and innovation. If Kima has two range, upgraded her range is three. Yeah, she has two range upgrades. Because I'm thinking like a tower is one range. Well, a tower is different. Because a tower is a base of one. But for unit, it'll only say range. You know what I mean? But yeah, you're saying the right thing. So she only has two range upgrades right there. So I'm guessing, yeah, I should back up then. So, one, two. One, two. So she would attack. Yeah. She has a talent range one, so range. Okay. Gotcha. So he will attack for one, two. There we go. And now next turn go. One, two. One, two. Spire's fire. That spire will attack the Swabby, which is going to do the same thing. Yep. Kill the Swabby, and I will promote. I will spend the two source there, which I did. And that will promote this guy. I don't know why I would want to promote him, honestly. He's kind of ass. Whatever. Only two health, but he's at range. Well, actually, no, I'm not even going to promote him because he doesn't have the range. Yeah, I'm not even going to promote him. So, this guy is going to attack the tower, and then the flying guy is also going to attack the tower, so they'll knock two off. If you want to promote, him using land launch pad 3, not using Swabbies. Yeah, but the thing is, like, I just don't have enough source yet, but yeah, I mean, that's, I wasn't looking at that. They transport other people across. Okay. Enemies go, so he will attack, and he is going to kill the flying guy. Because he can. Okay, next is us. So we are going to be moving. One, two. Spire's fire with one attack dice. Here we go. Oh, there it goes. There we go. One damage. That one's out of range. And then we're going to attack. We're going to take this tower out. Giving us three source. They're going to go. King will attack for two. And he'll retaliate for two. Ooh, I'm going to have a heal for two instead. No, I'll have retaliate for two. And then our turn. So we're going to go one, two. Both spires will fire one at a time. Go on. Corsair. Use a powder monkey as a promoted... Put a powder monkey in a promoted gladiator and watch the fortress melt away. Yeah, I think you might be right. I think that's a strategy I'm missing here, man. Do you know when this unit is defeated, all units, spires, and fortress gates adjacent to this unit take damage. Then adjacent spires take an additional one damage. I think that's what I was missing, man, Mark. I think you broke through there. Okay, so wave is over. Roll the event dice. One, which is increase your cannonball by one, and you may increase the air fortress gate by one. Okay, so we got two cannonballs. And this is now at 12. Okay. Now we'll go to build phase. And I do have three source, exactly what I need to build. That's Shadow Skiff. Place it here. Bring us down to zero. And I can put an upgrade on the bottom of any tower. Problem is, Keem's within range of that tower now. What's the other one? What's the directional attack one do? Where's the other one? The gun belt. Or source. I don't have the source for it. Damn. The reason I was putting a shadow skip there, because I was going to just swap one of these lifeboats out there. That was my thought behind it. If I put the shadow skiff there, I can just swap this ship, put that ship there, and rock and roll. Because that ship's gonna have free range. I'm trying to knock Keem out. That's what I was trying to do really hard. You're coming to Humming Hummer Joust Joust Roll Talent, so the two Hummers are gonna be grouped together. That's my idea behind that. And look, Mark, I've been doing this mission like 10 times already, man, so maybe that's not the best idea. Humminger Joust Joust, there's only one joust because I captured the other one. And Rural Talent. But you can't. You can only swap the one. Oh! Damn it. Yeah, you're definitely right. We just literally talked about that, bro. Yes, you're right. Crap. Yep. There's no point of putting it here. Well, my entire plan was useless now. Because I'm like locking all these upgrades on this guy just so I can do that swap. Okay, well. We're constructing Shadow Rift skiffs and lifeboat spires at add one fortification upgrade. Okay. We're going to put an attack upgrade on this tower here. I'm gonna build a skiff over here. Shut. Can't build a skiff over there. Four, three. Bring this to zero. And then that's what we're gonna do there. Okay, now we have nine source. Three, six, nine, seven, eight, nine. Six, seven, eight. Seven, eight. Alright, let me see this denote one more time. Denote. Detonate. Not denote. Detonate. When the machine is defeated, all units, spires, and fortresses adjacent to it take 2 damage. Then, adjacent spires take an additional 1 damage. Okay. Okay. Swabby on him. And, so 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have 4 points left. A little bit gunnery. Gunnery. To need to bring out another swabby. Debt onate. Yeah, dude, my bad. Oh my. Denote. You know what I mean? Oh my god, Mark. Alright, so they go first. Our turn. Okay, we're gonna swap this tower out with this one. Luna build option. And that's one limited build option right there. Then we're gonna move 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3. 13. Okay. So our attack, boom, bada bang, we're done. So next they can go. And now it is our turn. So here we go. A lot of units here. Okay. Sucks. Okay, now it's their turn. Okay, and he will kill this tower. Okay. Okay, our turn. Okay, and then back to them. But spire's fire, they would attack. He's going to kill the elf and cause up the top, giving us 2 swords. Okay, they're going to go. Okay, Spires. Well, they're going to quick strike, so he is going to move one of these up. What the hell's going on here? Attack range, but it's backwards. He'll just remove the attack off of this one here. Off of this one here. Okay. And then as far as fire, so two attack dice into that Hummingbird. Ooh, 3 damage, it kills it, giving us 2 source. Wow. And then that one's going to do 1 attack dice, and a new Hummingbird is going to come out with an Elfenkazi on top, and he would snipe the Elfenkazi out right away. So this air defense is just going to attack the Elfenkazi sitting on top. 1 damage, killing it, giving us another 2 source. We're at 6. So then they're going to attack. So that guy will attack for 1 here. And the other guy is going to kill my glide bomb. My gliders. Okay, now it is our turn. Well, technically, if I'm correct here, the first elf prize that was there didn't die if you attacked the Hummingbird. It was already dead. My glide bomb sniped it out back here. Yeah, because my glide bomb sniped it out the glider. He sniped it out before it made it to there. But the problem here is, I don't think what I did here. Oh, yeah, that was the. No, I think it's good to go. Okay, so that's our move action. Yep. So he's going to slap this, which will. Damn. Spend 2 source and that's a more gun. And we're going to promote. Yep. Why not? Okay. So we're good. Maybe we should just 1, 2. Actually, we're gonna, we can't go for 3. Yeah, we'll just pick one up. Okay, next is the enemy's turn. So, 1, 2. He'll quick strike. They'll both quick strike the tower, killing it. Well, no quick strike on that, just the roost is going to quick strike. The joust can quick strike. And then, as far as fire, doing the 2 attack on the Harrier, on the Hummingbird, not the Harrier, here we go. 2 damage. And this tower is going to attack the Hummingbird with 1 attack dice. 2 damage, so killing it, giving us 2 source. Brings back up to 6, and now it is our turn. One, two. Okay, as far as fire attack, I'm going to slap this guy. He's going to retaliate for 3, killing him, which will promote the powder monkey. two swords to save his ass. And I save the other guy too. And then the gunnery guy is just going to attack it for two. Okay, now it's their turn. Just seem risky to leave that one on the die, but you're allowed to have a joust attack. But maybe you didn't want to. Yeah, it just seemed risky to leave that one to die. Yeah, I don't know what else to do with it, man, honestly. So this guy's going to go 1-2. He will kill this tower here. Royal Talon retaliates. Well, he would have, but my guy slapped him. I had a swabby slap him. This unit attacks and retaliates. If, you know, so my swabby, well, he killed my swabby, so that's why he didn't retaliate against my gunner. Because my swabby took the hit for... Spires fire, so we're going to this guy two attack dice into the Royal Talent. Two damage. Okay, now it is our turn. Okay. How? I had a swabby. Oh, he's flying. Damn it, Mark, you got me there, bro. Oh my god, we should just play together, man. Bro, yeah. At this point, we should just play together, man. I'm calling back. Oh my god, dude, this game is so much. Oh. Yes, thank you, Mark, for clearing that up. Freaking A, man. What a freaking A. And notice that said PETA, not PETA. Okay, so we can just undo all that. The undoing is the hard part. Damn it, I don't know what I had. I know this is here. Okay, so we're going to undo just the one step here. Oh, no, Mark, don't, man. So he can't slap. I guess he slaps the joust, and the joust kills him. So that work. Then I spend a two source there. Is that three health? And it's going to attack the joust at that point. Do two damage to the joust. Okay, so now it is their turn. So in this case, he will attack the tower because he can kill a tower. Or he can destroy, hero can destroy, aspire he can defeat. Yep, so the quick strike will be on this tower here. From the joust one here. Then the flying guy doesn't attack because I got spyglass, and spyglass is you flying units cannot attack this unit. Okay, now it is our turn, so 1-2, 1-2-3, Cloudspire's fire, and then we get to attack. Oh wait, I still have to roll the dice though for this tower here. I'm gonna roll against it. Roll tower. Maybe not. I'll just pull the plank. I'm gonna roll against it. You're gonna roll against the. We'll roll against the roll talent for now. 2 damage. Okay, and this guy who heal fire at Keem. 1-2. Damn it, and Keem will retaliate back. We're not doing that. We're gonna fire two at the joust and kill the joust. Giving us 2 sword springs back up to 6. Okay, now it's enemy's turn. Tower's fire, so 2 attack dice against the bird. He has royal talent. Oh my god, 4 damage. Oh, that's super sweet, giving us springs up to 10. And then Keem is going to attack for 2. And he'll retaliate back for 2. Okay, now it is our turn. So I'm going to spend 1 source as a limited build option. This is my 2nd limited build option. And I'm going to put a rigging station here. And we are going to take this guy back to base. Next, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, Spires fires, we get to attack. I'm gonna kill Keem, give me 3 source, 1, 2, 3. Okay, and there you go, back to us. So, Spire's fire, 1 dice into there. Damage, another dice coming in from this one into there. Nothing. Ooh, do I tap D? Okay, so this guy is going to hit this tower here. Maybe I shouldn't worry about that. Maybe I should just worry about the base. Well, this guy's going to attack this tower here. And no retaliate. Okay. And then they go. We go. Spire's fire. So this one will attack into here. 2 damage killing him. Gunnery is down. Okay, and now that tower is going to attack into our guy. 2 damage, also killing him. So this is going to be. Denote, detonate. When this unit is defeated, all units, Spires and Fortress Gates, chase this unit, take 2 damage. So, going down 4. Then the Jason Spires take an additional 1 damage. going to give us a one source. That's a great play there. Okay. And that's one source, bring us up to 13. And now that's the end of the wave, and we start the next turn. So what do we got going on here? Okay, so two build options are removed. Let's see the event dice. Let's see what we get for the event dice. It's a five. Five is ignore her upgrade capacity. Okay, well, Keem is dead. Oh, I see what you're saying. It's just talent one range. I see what you're saying about that on paper. Okay, so that's sweet. Now it's our build turn. What are we doing here? Definitely need to build two Powder Monkeys. 3, 6. And we have 11 swords. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Well, first thing we're going to do is build options. We're going to upgrade one of our towers for free. So first thing we're going to do is we're constructing Shadow Rift, add one fortification for 3, bring us down to 10. That is launch bay level 2. And then man glider down to 7. The glider may be selected for deployment on its promoted side. Flying breakneck transports. And transport, I think, is only one unit. You must get flank cannons. You must get flank cannons. They're already unlocked, I thought. 1A and 1B is already unlocked for the scenario, I thought. Mark, I wish I had your memory, man. You have such amazing memory, dude. First, I start scenario with gun deck A, cord cannons, and gun deck B, flank cannons, fortress advancements. No, man. That is not true, bro. You're definitely not that. So I'm trying to get rid of... Can I group? I guess he's the slowest. I gotta read the grouping. Does the whole entire group have to be in speed order, or can you have one slow, one fast, and one slow underneath? B H I J K L A B E F G. Group. Main group must allow to act as one unit using the stats and talents of the topmost unit. Groups formed during prep phase by stacking as many units as you would like to get in order from lowest to highest movement stats. Yep, okay. Makes sense. That got answered. Thank God we have for the rules reference, man. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11. I just left 3 source. 3 command points. Okay, let's try this. Six, 7, 8, 9, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. That's it. Okay, so here. Okay, and I'm still gonna spend some more command points. So I got the 3 for there. So 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Okay, so I'm still gonna do some more upgrading here first. I am going to spend. Oh, I can't do that either. Huh. I'm gonna spend 3, and I'm gonna build another rigging outpost. Not a rigging, one of these little sneak shifters. There. Okay. And then I am going to. I gotta get this cannon the hell out of here. Well, technically, I gotta get this cannon opened up, which I want to do this code. Okay, so they're gonna have their stack is Windrush, Joust. Windrush is not promoted, but the Joust is. Humminger. Humminger with. Okay. Joust. Harrier. And then rural talent promoted. Wow. One, two, three, four, five, six. Okay. Don't want to do. I'm gonna spend the last 2 source, and I'm going to get last 4 source. I'm gonna get 2 more cannons. Okay, so we go first. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to swap this boat with this boat here as one build option. Then I'm going to swap this one with this one here as a second build option. Oh, and I have to get an upgrade, that's right. I can upgrade on any spire. So let me put an attack upgrade on this one. Okay. So we're looking pretty good there, Mark. I feel like we might move somewhere now. So we go first, and that was my 2 limited build options. So we're done with that. Okay. And 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. 1, 2. Oh man, 1, 2, 3, 4. And now they're gonna go. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. Okay, now it is back to us. So, God. Yeah, effing won this game. Unless my can rolls a 2. Let's try it. I'm gonna have my cannon shoot one of its bullets on this one here. I need to roll a 2. Hello, other people in chat. Slava is about to win. Just in time to see. I don't think I am, man. I just realized that I thought I was gonna have Miss Van come down here on this turn right now, right? That's why I'm gonna attack this to kill it, but the problem is it's freaking engaged, man. It's altercation of aggression, dude. It looks like Pistolier can avoid that somehow. He cannot. So, I don't know now how I'm gonna win, man. So that's what's gonna pull a bolt down. I'm gonna shoot my cannon into here and see what happens. I need to roll a 2, man. So we're shooting for 2 of us right now. Oh my god. Did you guys catch that? Did you just catch that, dude? Oh, it's off camera. Oh my god. Dude, we technically did it. Oh my god. Now I think we are gonna win, man. But I gotta stroll the spires, though. And those guys don't walk on forests, do they? No, they don't. So 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 1, 2. Dude, but the problem is, Mark, I don't know how I'm gonna get this, man. We'll see, man. Still got cannon shots to shoot at the base. But I gotta get this tower down. Oh, this is so much, man. Okay. We're done. They're gonna go. Boom, boom. And this guy needs to have an elephant on top of him. Okay. Damn, dude. Okay. As far as fire, 1, 2, 3. We do the range on this one. I can't see. What is that? Where did it go? Oh, 1 damage. Okay. Now it is, he attacks for 1. We retaliate for 1. Next is... our turn. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 4. That worked out really nice for actually for us. That worked out really nice for us, man. 1, 2. 1, 2. Sparse fire attack. get this last one here. And I'm going to have the glider attack the Elfenkazi, killing that. So no retaliate. Okay, that's one source. They're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. 1, 2. Quick strike. He is going to attack the range off of this. Spires get to attack. So we're going to have this tower attack the Windrush. That's 3 dice. 3 damage. Killing it. Nice, 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 nice. That brings a Motor Joust and 4 on there. Okay. And then this tower is going to attack that joust for 1 attack dice and 1 damage to it. Now the joust is now going to attack phase. This joust is going to do one of these. And it's going to kill this one, which will promote my buccaneer. And it's also going to kill my other swabby. No, Mark, I think one thing in realizement, I wish I could delete messages I send on Twitch. No, man. Tax the hero. Oh, I see what you're saying. Nah, dude, it's legit all good, bro. Oh, crap, they should be there. That was, they have 10 health right now. Bro, I need you to send these messages. So this swabby dies and brings up this drunk monkey. Okay, so now it is our turn. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3. Okay. So none of these guys can move. Spires fire into my hair, into my glide bomber right there. Oh my god. No damage. That is going my way, dude. I think at this point I'm going to attack the base for 1. Bring it down to 9 health. And then he'll die. Yep. Now, I'm going to do some tricky stuff here. So I'm going to use my Pistolier to shoot. Pistolier is attacking this unit. May attack an opposing unit up to 2 hexes away. If it does, flip this unit to the other side. Remove any upgrades of your choice. Remove an upgrade of your choice. So you don't understand. And remove an upgrade of your choice. I guess there's some units in the game that have multiple upgrades. That's how I'm reading that. So I am going to have Pistolier is going to shoot the joust for 1. This guy is going to kill the powder monkey is going to kill the joust, giving us 2 source, bringing us up to 3. And then the buccaneer is going to kill the harrier, giving us 1 source. And that's the powder monkey, drunk monkey. Yeah. Okay, next is enemy phase. Okay. 1, 2, One, two, three. He will quick strike, and he will quick strike the tower in this case. Spire's fire. Oh, he's going to attack the lifeboat's going to attack the Harrier. One damage. Okay. And its air defense is going to attack the what is the Harrier gonna attack? This tower is going to attack the guy in front of me with 3 attack damage. The Hummingar. No, we couldn't do it. Resist that. Make everybody's life easier. 4 damage, killing it, giving us 2 swords. And that is going to bring out a elephant cousin. Now the Hummingar will attack this one for 1. And the Royal Tap will attack that for 1. Okay, now it is our turn. Okay, we're going to shoot our cannon 3 times at their base. Actually, we'll see. So, we're going to do our moon phase. So moving phase, is that it for us? Okay, that's it for us. So this guy used a pistol, so he should be flipped over from last turn. I can use a pistol in this guy. 3-2-2. Take the Hummingar. Yep, I am going to just kill this Harrier here. Yep, kill the Harrier here, giving us 1 source. Up to 7. Okay, and that's and then oh wait, the Spire's gonna fire there. On my base, on my Darken Monkey, so for 1. And I'm going to attack the tower, removing 1 of its fortifications. Okay, and now they go. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this guy's gonna go first. 1, 2, 3. Here. Tower's fire. This one's going to attack the Hummingar on the bottom. So we'll get that E there. Actually, this is probably a little better on this side. There's a lot happening right here. Yeah, if I see a little this tower's in the way. I'll move this tower. Well done, it's gonna be dead in a second. So let's go here. Boom. So this tower is going to attack humming underneath. 1 damage. Oh, no, you can't see the dice being rolled. That's fine. And then this tower is going to attack the... Wait. Yep, it's going to attack the Elfin Kazi. Yeah, it's going to attack the Elfin Kazi. So two attack decks and Elfin Kazi, here we go. Yep. Just one damage, killing it. Giving us two swords. Up to nine. Now they attack, movement upgrade here. And this one will kill this tower here. Now we can open up that space up for everybody to see what's going on here a little more. There we go. Now it's Archer. That's fire's gonna fire. A one, killing it. So he'll do 2 damage to the base. And then remove this tower. Give him this one source. Okay. And now 1, 2, 3. And this guy will kill the Elfin Kazi here. Two source. 12. Okay. And now we go to his move face. So 1, 2. Actually, he's gonna go 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. No sparks can fire. That's it for him. So Archer, so 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, and then okay, so he'll... now it's their turn, he's gonna come here. Oh, he's gonna attack for 4. Retaliate for 1. I can't pull the plank because I won't be able to get the last sorcerer back to base, so I'm gonna use my cannon and shoot 3 times at the base. 1 damage, 2 damage, 3 damage. 1, 2, 3. Okay. And now it's Archer, so 1, 2. Now it's his turn to attack for 4. Retaliate for 1. Why can't you pull the plank? Because my hero will become defeat the Forge Gate. Well, oh crap! I should have saved the one cannon for the last shot. God damn. I forgot that you have to the last shot has to be from the cannon. Well, the reason why I can't pull the plank mark is because if I pull the plank, my hero's gonna go into campfire mode. And he's carrying the last source. Well, oh, I see your campfire modes. Yep. So even if I, either way, I still can't get three renown even with the cannon shot, because I have to pull the plank now to save my base from dying. But it's not going to be enough, and I didn't have a build option. I was going to build a rigging site, but dang. You also skill need to kill yours. What? What? Beat the air's gate while there are no spires. Oh boy, I did not see that. Doesn't look like you can get any renown looking at this scenario. I didn't read that right, man. Defeat the air's gate with a cannonball. Defeat the air's gate while there are no spires in play. I thought there was no air spires in play. Jeez, man. Return all source capsules to your fortress. Yeah, there's a no renown win right here, man. Yeah, wow. And if so, what your morale dice is showing at the end of the scenario. This one. Know whether you have Captain's 1, Morale, Fortress, Advancement. And if so, what your morale dice is showing at the end of the scenario. This will affect whether you have advancements in the next scenario. Yeah, I don't think I can get any renown. Well, literally now it's an hour and a half. I'm gonna die either way, and I can't get over now for nothing. So yep, we're gonna call this scenario right now, quits right now. I should get the morale dice. Gain the morale dice set to 0. Treat this dice as a counter for each opposing unit you defeat through the fortress dilation, cannon damage, or pulling the plank. Increase die by 1. During the prep phase, you may decrease the die by amount to gain that many CP. I need to gain that morale dice, man. Okay. Well, best I can do right now is just... Man. At this point, Mark, we should just play the game against each other, dude. Ridiculous. Keem. Powder monkey, buccaneer. Okay. I almost think also I have to get my last hero out. Unless I get my that guy out. I'm surprised you never got promotion. For Mistbang, I did, but I used the Pistolier to drop him back down. Like, I promoted him, but I used the Pistolier. You never got promotion. What is promotion? Swabbies may be selected for deployment on the promoted side. Oh. I didn't really understand it in this scenario, because the advantage they had was emboldened. If this unit is defeated by a group, the newly revealed unit may immediately move and attack. This unit does not count. This does not count as the newly revealed unit's movement or attack for the turn. See, here's what I don't understand about that. So let's just give an example here, right? let's say, where's the swab yet? Let's give this example here, right? Let's say I have a swabby here. Okay. Let's make it nice and simple here. We'll bring her here, Mark. Okay, let's say I have... a swabby there, right? So, let's do it this way. Yeah, that's correct. So let's say... the royal town attacks it, kills it, right? The next guy underneath gets promoted. Right? So then he can move and attack. Hey, man, I know, wow, right? It's Cloudspire, bro. So we're just going over some rule references then. Yeah, thanks for the follow-up, but we're going over some rule references. So, Mark, let's run this one here really quick. So, just to be sure, let's say the swabby here is... here, royal town attacks it, right? Kills it. He promotes the guy underneath, the gunnery. And then let's say the gunnery. So the gunnery can now move and attack. So even though it's not his turn, even though it's not our movement turn, am I getting that right? And board game. Oh, in Italia. Gotcha, man. I was going to say board game Italia. Maybe Mark might help me with referencing here. Even though it's not my turn, he'll still be able to go 1-2 and attack, correct? But then here's the next question. If he attacks the royal talent, does the royal talent retaliate? I'm going to say you're going to say yes. Which will lead me to another question once you answer it. So let's see how this goes. Italia. Only if you're adjacent. Okay, now let's run another scenario, right? Here we go. We'll run this scenario. Let's say Swabby attacks. Hits him, he retaliates, kills him, right? So this guy promoted, comes out. So now he can move. 1-2. And he can attack him. Well, let's say it was adjacent. That attack then wouldn't retaliate either then. Because he already retaliated against the swabby. So you already answered that one. You don't need to answer. I think I got that one. Let's see what Mark says. Board game Italia. This is Cloudspire, if you know what this is. This monstrosity here. What is Mark going to say to that? I think he's going to say the same thing. Because he already attacked. Because he already retaliated by slapping guy. Now the guy gets the move. Yeah, Mark, I'm going to... And this is why we're playing these factions, you know what I mean? This is why we play. To learn. LOL, you said I didn't. Then you went. Yeah, I love that, man. Yeah, I think the answer was right there. Yeah, Mark. Thank God you're here, man, because I'm making so many little mistakes. Oh, Mark, and we are hosting a tournament on the end of April around my birthday for this game. $50 is a lot prize for the first place winner. So if you want to fly down here and spend $400 to win $50, you're more local, you can lodge in this great estate here. If you wanted to, nobody's forcing you. Nobody's forcing you. Okay, so now that we know those couple things, Mark, we're going to retry the scenario now. A couple other things. $50, Mark. Feliz birthday. Who's Feliz? Feliz. Yeah. So. Mark. You know how I pronounce words, man. I almost said board game Italia. But it's board game meat. Board game. Board game. It is board game Italia. I almost said board game Italia. Alright, so what we're gonna do is what should I do here? I should probably just reset quick and run it one more time. Let's do it one more time. So where is Keem at? One range. Oh. Oh, you're right. You ain't in California. Everyone speaks Spanglish over here. Police is happy in Spanish. Oh, my man. No, I'm around a bunch of Amish people, man. Let me show you what. Actually, I kind of show you my outdoors. Show what outside looks like right now. Give me a sec. I'm in the middle of the woods, man. I don't know if Martin takes camera, but. That's the world out there, man. Well, he's in the wooded cabin area. Bada boom, bada bang. Here's Gloomhaven. Mark, that's the map. As you can tell, Forgotten Circles. We are literally one mission away from beating that. And it's been a nightmare, dude, so that's all I can tell you about that. Oh. Get this camera reset back up. Boom. Good. Whoa, nice. Yeah, the board Gloomhaven? I know, what can I say? We're gonna start the Frosthaven campaign. We might be looking for one more person. But we need commitment. Alright, so let me get this reset. Here you're just. Double check everything. I'm gonna shuffle the earthscapes. Quite the Chad Gloomhaven savant you are. Dude. I mean, honestly, bro, we've been playing the last mission probably. We played last mission probably 5 times. No. For sure 5 times already. The last mission can't beat it. That's for the Forgotten Circles. So. We can't beat it, man. We have been playing it like non-stop. Okay, I need to get some towers up too, so. Attack range indication. That's insane. We gotta destroy their gate. And in the process to have all of our towers get destroyed. I'm trying to think if that would be done. It's gotta be done, can be done. So I mean it's gotta be done. It's been done. You guys done it, so it's gotta be done. This is one. Okay, I think that's air defense. And this one I think is also rigging. Okay. Okay, well, I guess this is attempt number seven for us here. Hmm. Yeah, this is attempt number 7 for us, so... I'm not sure if things have been set up. I keep the map set up the same. The only thing I change is the roll for the event dice for the first round. Yeah, I'm missing. Okay, see, because here's the thing, man. And this is in this scenario book, right here. I guess, see, because this was a minaret spire here. Because I'd use this number 13, I'd put it here. The minaret spire got removed, and it says I could put... Oh, that's right. It says I could put, for the source wall in the earthscape, you may choose which landmark type swamp, temple, or ruin is placed here. Right, but I did forget about that. Okay, so I can choose this one I want to go there. I want the Trexar Loner to go there, so I want to go there. I guess I'll have them there. It's fine, I'm not worried. Okay, so... we start from step one. Let's roll the event dice. It's a 3. You immediately fire a cannonball one of your cannons. If you hit one of your own spires, yeah, but the problem is I have no cannons to fire, so. Okay, well that doesn't help us there, so. First wave, I think it's gonna be Harrier, and then Chaps. Correct. One. 2, 3. And they need 2 minaret spires on their base. Attack range, fortification, attack range, fortification. Okay, King Spires upside down. Yeah, I just fixed that. Mark, how much time you got left, man? We should just play a game against each other, man. You probably don't have any time left now at all. It's been 2 hours. Damn. Okay, so first things first is 5 command points. I'd be go away that confident. I'd be doing it, but they ain't confident. I started fucking here. Problem is, I won't be able to capture the Harriers. It's the Buccaneer. Fly bomb. Right, so here we go. 1, 2, 3. They go first. All right, and then that was them, and now it goes to us. Okay. Time for one guard. My only advice for this game. Fifteen minutes left. Why would I not deploy the glider? There's that. My only advice for this game. Why would Mark say that? If it's not the glider, then I'm either stuck with one buccaneer, one gunner, or one corvusset. I'll try that, Mark. I'll try and go with just this setup here. So it would be here. Their turn. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So then he's going to attack here. Spire's was going to attack the one in the back with two attack dice. Here we go, skip better. 3 damage, killing it, giving us one source. This is going to attack the one here. One dice, which is, I'll reroll it. It's a 2, but I'll reroll it. Blank now. That's why I like using the map that I don't. Because the rule, if I use Mattis, it has fallen mat to be legal. And then it falls out and it's like a 2 and I really need that. It's like, oh, God, I can't believe that fell out. So it's like the mat's kind of like my... Not my best friend, not my worst friend. Okay, our turn. This guy would be here. 1, 2, 3, we'll put him here. So... two, three. One, two. Sparse fire, attack, movement. They go here. Go quick strike for two. And I will retaliate for two. For one. One, two. And then, you know what I should deploy instead, man? I should strip deploy the powder monkey. I'm trying to change a Corsairian out with the powder monkey. See how that plays out. Okay, so that was Archer now. One of the two heroes gonna stay there. Sparse fire and then attack phase. I will kill this guy. Getting me a promotion. Okay, and that's enemy's turn, so one, two, he will quick strike. All right, then it's our turn, so one, two, three. One, two, sparse fire. Oh, wait, my spire is supposed to attack that, so two attack dice first. About to do that. There you go. Two twos, look at that. Three damage to him, which kills him. Give us two source. Okay. Now we move, which we just did. Exploration. Yep, we're going to spring this. Alright, Swabby's going to slap it. I'm going to pay. I'm not gonna pay any source to bring back impressive damage. I know, man, but the problem was like it went off the mat. So that's why I don't like using this, but I do, but I don't. You know what I mean? Ah, is what it is. I'm not gonna give some fun. I still killed it, so. So then this guy is gonna use attack of two. He's gonna use his ability called Swap. When she attacks, she may increase the damage for each opposing unit adjacent to it. Okay, next is their turn, and it's going to go back to us. One, two, three. Sparse fire, exploration. Yeah, why not? He's gonna attack for two. He can retaliate for two. We're gonna kill a relentless. Give him his fire source. Bring us up to nine. Okay. Then it is their turn. They're done. Back to us. I'm gonna come here. Must stay there. One, two, three. Sparse fire. Two attack dice. One damage, killing it, so he does two damage here. Then moves these two. That's a pretty big one for us. Okay. And, well, first I was going to attack this hero first so I could pick that up. And then I did that. Now the wave ends and I go to wave two. Let's roll the event dice. Six. And he gets range upgrade. Son of a god, man. Okay, and we go to build phase. So, now to upgrade chip in bottom end tower. Okay, then we got 9 command points, so we're gonna spend. Three to get the launch bay level 1 unlocked. That's the idea there. So now we can build shadow skiffs and lifeboats. Then we are going to get. Oh, I get the glider right away, fully upgraded. I'm gonna spend the last 6, and I'm gonna get the promoted swappies and see what happens there. Which is stowaway level 1 on hold. Swappies cost 1 less to return your base, and hold level 2 swappies, maybe to put in the promoted side. So we'll see what happens here. So, they're gonna have Barrier here, Joust come out. And the Joust are gonna be promoted. So. Okay, and then it is, we can put an upgrade, which we already did, and now we go to the, seven. Okay, so we're going to get the two swabbies out. Two of these powder monkeys, why not? Three, six. And we're actually gonna group them together. Let's try this and see what happens. Okay, we go first this turn. I really like that six source. Well, they come out the boat side, so. Okay. One big group, interesting, excited to see how this plays out. Ah, me too, man. I'm like. Yeah. So we get to go first. So, one, two. There you go. I am going to keep. One, and I'm going to pick one up. Okay, they're going to go. Okay, back to us. I don't know the source, damn. One, two there. Then back to them we go. Quick strike. Quick strike. Quick strike. Powers fire. So two attack dice in here. One damage and one attack dice in here. One damage. Okay. Our turn. One, two. My hero's gonna stay there. Next, they're gonna go. One, two, three. He will swap. This happens after move phase, so technically, let's just do this. Now the swap's gonna happen. So he'll kill this, revealing that on his promoted side. And that cost me one source to keep. I don't have the source, so we lose that. This guy is going to rotate this one, leave two damage to it. Then we'll retaliate back to it. Now it's our turn. Okay. As far as attack base, I'm going to use his swashbuckle, killing that, giving us no source, nothing. But he does get a. Oh! Don't forget. Oh! Which happens first? Let's rewind that. Mark, we can always rewind this, man. I totally forgot about it, man. Hold on a second. So, boom, boom. Totally forgot about it, dude. And that joust had... How much health did he have? How much health did he... Doom, you spent 6 swords to use embodied. Do it. Well, here's the thing. I forgot how much swords he had. He had 2, that's right, because he attacked that guy. Did he have 4 or did he have 2? I think he had 2 because my towers. I forgot how much source he had, man. 1, 2, 3. Because he killed that thing. I think he actually has full source. I guess full source. Which is using body. I know, man. I forgot that, like, I had that. And this guy was here. Oh man, I don't know the exact setup. I think the setup was that. Go, oh, so. 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, yep. This would be the third turn, correct? 1. Yep, this is the third turn. So 1, 2, 1, 2, and now it's their turn here. That's right. And see, was their Harrier dead? Ah, I forget. We'll start from here. So 1, 2, 3. I do know it's like this. 1, 2. I just don't know how many health the Joust had. Believe it or not, I don't know why I would have less. So he's going to do this. Killing it. Revealing this guy. Now, here's a question mark. Actually, it's a perfect question here, man. So, if he attacked my powder monkey, when my powder monkey attacks him back, does he retaliate? See what I mean? Would he retaliate in a sense? But for he attacked my Swabby, when Swabby died, emboldened happens, powder monkey comes out. If he attacks him back, will the Joust retaliate, even though he attacked him on the same turn? I'm gonna say you're gonna say yes. But I just wanna be sure what the thought is on that. Yep. So I'm gonna hit this guy for 2. I'm gonna retaliate for 2. Now this guy's gonna fury kick. Yep, let me see the chart. It hasn't retaliated this turn, that's right. Opposing units, forts can support, heroes can defeat, and spires can defeat. Technically then, this logic won't even make sense. He won't even attack me because he'll actually attack the spire. Reason being is the Spire has, he can defeat the Spire, and the Spire is higher on a birdie level than a faction minion can defeat. So in this case, actually, he won't even attack me. Technically, by default, he'll actually attack the Spire, moving that. But then that guy won't be able to attack. Now this Spire does get the fire. And I'm gonna fire this dice into this guy here. 3 attack dice. Oh, this far only has one yet. It hasn't retaliated this turn. It attacks it. Yep. Okay, so this tire is firing 2 damage at... the joust in the back. No damage at all. Okay. So then now it's our turn. No, it sucks. Okay, so we are going to slap this guy. He retaliates, killing us. I don't get him. He goes up promoted with 3 health. And he's going to smack him for 2. Oh, wait. Yep. And don't want to use a pistol there and shoot at him. Pistol's only going to do 1 damage, so shooting him is also going to be useless too. Yeah, thanks, Mark. Dude, I appreciate you sitting in and just helping it understand some of the rules, man. Really appreciate that, man. Okay, now it's their turn, so... he's going to quick strike. And the quick strike, the fury kick is... And he will retaliate for 2, killing it, giving us 2 source. Now, this guy will do a fury kick also. Killing him. So no retaliate there. And that's going to have the tires fire then, 2 attack dice. 2 damage. And now it is our turn. Okay. Well, before I do that, do I want to... Oh, Mark, one more question before you bounce. The spire's fire... If that unit comes out to the spires, do the enemy spires get to attack it on that turn? You probably already left. But that's all good, man. I'll ask you later, Mark.
Damn.
I'm pretty sure they would. Okay, so I'm going to use his swashbuckler. Killing it, it's not going to give us any... Actually, I'm not even going to do that. I'm just going to let him go. But I will build a lifeboat for 1 before we move base. Okay. And then I'll just move him, so yep, that's it for us. Now his turn, so 1, 2, 3, he will remove the attack dice here. As far as fire, so this will attack it for 1 dice. 1 damage, and then this will attack it for 1 dice. No damage.
Okay.
Okay, now it is our turn, so we're going to teleport back to base. Okay. And this is gonna go 1, 2, 3. Spars fire, they don't attack. Okay, now it is their turn, so 1, 2, 3. He will attack for 2 damage, and we will retaliate, killing it, giving us 2 source. Okay. This one's going to, oh wait, and then he is going to kill this guy here, which we're going to pay 1 source to save. And this guy comes out promoted with 3 health. He's going to activate right away. 1, 2, 3. That's my question there. When does Towers retaliate? That's really the question I have to ask. Retaliate on towers need the rules reference. So let's just see what the rule reference says there for towers retaliating. When a unit is attacked by the fortress, okay. I guess tower fire, spire fire. Your opponent spires fire or attack on a specific stage of your turn during the onset phase. On your turn. Okay. So spires only fire on my turn. Okay. The player to your left checks if you, as a current player, have any units in the range of their spires. For each attacking spire, they must choose target the mobile targets. Then the next opposing player in turn does the same until all opposing players have a chance to fire the spires. Units do not retaliate against spires. Spires can attack landmarks, spires, fortress gates, and units belong to players that are not currently taking their turn. Okay, very nice. Thank you, Mark. I got the answer there. So since that was on his turn that he shot me, I'm going to go here, and I am going to... Damage the spire. It's going to give us 3 source. Here's up to 5. Next, it is our turn. Because that was the embolden that happened there. I am going to this will move up. Sparse fire. So this tower attacks first. No damage. And then the other tower is going to attack right now with 1 damage. When I get to attack, I'm going to attack this spire and I'm going to remove the fortification upgrade. Okay, their turn, they can't shoot him because of spyglass. Now it's back to us, stay there, spire is fire. This one will attack first. 1 damage, and now the spire is going to attack. 2 damage, killing him. This is where he does the detonate. Does 2 damage to the fortress. 9, 8, 8, and then he'll remove the spire. Give him this 1 source up to 6. And that was it for there. So now we go to the next wave. Wave 3, roll the event dice. Let's see what we get from the event dice. A 1. Defeat the increase your cannonball size 1 and increase the Harry's fortress by 1. Okay, next is the build phase, and We're gonna spend 3 source. We're gonna put this shadow skiff out here. Then I'm gonna spend another 3 source, bringing another shadow skiff out here. I don't want to do that. Yes, I do. Okay, now we're gonna. They're gonna have. This is 7 command points. Yeah, I think it's 7 command points. So we're going to now add an upgrade to the bottom of one of our towers. Let's add an attack upgrade to this air defense here. Okay, and now we're going to go to the next step, which is building their base. They're gonna have Harry Joust, which would have that. So they were 9 command points now. So Humminger, Joust, Royal Defense. Humminger, Joust, Royal Talent. Okay. And that is going to put us to 1 Elf and Kazi on top of that. We have 9 command points. So 4. 5, 6, 7. We have 9. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yep, we'll do this. Here we go. That's all run out with. We'll run out with this setup right here. So this Miss Bane's coming out, and so is the Swashbuckler. Now we only have 1 guy left to do the promotion, so we gotta be careful here. Okay, and first person to go on that wave is Harris. Yep, okay, now it's back to us. That's them. We're gonna continue on now on our side. 1, 2. Oh, before we do that, we're going to do this. Okay. That's one limited build option. Okay. And I should have put this here. I'm gonna put this here instead. I didn't realize I can't do that from there. So this put here, we'll do this here. Okay, so now we're gonna move. 1, 2, 3. I'll swap these guys out too. Which is 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, like that. Okay, I know it's kind of a lot of finagling going on here, but there's just so much happening, so I feel bad if you guys are trying to figure out what's all this finagling happening here. Just trying to improvise as we're going. So now the enemies go. 1, 2. 1, 1, 1, 2. Okay, and now it is back to us. Oh, and this guy was supposed to attack this last turn. I'm sorry, guys. So that was supposed to, Fresh Tail was supposed to attack our tower, killing it. So, 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. Sparse fire exploration. Okay, and then it is their turn. 1, 2. Back to us. One, two, three. Sparse fire. And they go now. He's gonna quick strike, he's gonna kill this thing here, which joust this. And sparse fire, so this air defense tower is gonna attack the elephant Kazi. For one attack dice. Misses, and this guy's gonna roll two attack dice against the elephant Kazi. Two damage. Giving us resource. Okay, so next is going to be here. One, two. Sparse fire attack. I'm going to slap him. So he's going to get rid of him. I'm going to pay one source to save that guy. And he comes out promoted with 5 health. Alright, now he's got 5 health on him, so he will attack him for 2. Okay. Then, they go. Everybody stays there. The ace guy will quick strike this for 1. And then sparse fire. So 1 attack dice against the homeowner. Here we go. 2 damage, killing it. Giving us 2 source. That's going to bring out a new homeowner and a new elf and Kazi. So this guy is going to attack the hummer underneath. So 2 attack dice, here we go. 2 damage. Okay, now let's go to hierarchy order. Let's see what happens here. So, faction minion can landmark it can defeat. Hero can damage, 5 damage, faction minion can damage. So, technically, this guy is going to attack a tower he can damage, so he'll attack this tower here. Interesting. Now it's our turn, so. This guy will attack the Humminer, kill him, which will capture it for us. That gives us a capture. Elfenkazi still stays there. And that is the end of our turn. There you go. He's going to quick strike this. Elfenkazi will do nothing, and then Spire. This one will attack the bird. Elfenkazi for 1. Killing it, giving us 2 source. 5. This is going to attack the joust. 1 attack dice. Doing, again, no damage. Interesting. We can see a little bit from this angle what's going on here. So now it's our turn. Boom. Oh my gosh, this guy's supposed to go 1-2. That guy would have attacked this tower here. Okay. Now it's our turn, so we did that. And as far as fire, we need to attack. I'm gonna attack for 2. I'm gonna retaliate for 2. Okay, next is enemy's turn, they all go, they're gonna quick strike this tower. Killing it. And this one will fury kick. Doing 2 damage to it. And 2 damage. Oops. 2 damage to my guy here. Now I can either retaliate for 2, or I can just heal for 2. I'll retaliate for 2. Now it is our turn. Wait, yep, and that's fire. So this fire is gonna, oh, and this guy, this flying guy will actually he's going to kill this guy. Okay, so it's not looking too good right now. Now it's our turn. Boys, I'll tell you what, it is not looking too good. This is just mentally stressful. Ugh. This is attempt number 7 at this mission. Okay, then they're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Spire. I'm gonna attack the flying guy. 1 attack dice. I don't think I can beat this mission. 1 damage. And now it is our turn. Oh yeah, both these guys are gonna pick one of these up last turn. So he's gonna go here for one. So he's gonna do a pistol whip. He's gonna shoot him for one. And then, oh, wait. No, I'm not. I'm gonna move for one. And then I'm gonna straight damage him for two. Killing him, giving me two swords up to seven. And that gives an attack upgrade. So I'm going to give him. Yeah, okay, we'll give him attack upgrade. Then they go. So this unnerves is the layer. Okay, so they go. One, two, three. Two. This tower's gonna cane fire. Now it's our turn. One, two. This guy's gonna stay here. He's gonna pick the last one up. Alright, then they're gonna go here. He's gonna attack for two. And I will tally it for one. This guy will go one, two. Now it is our turn. One, yep, and he's gonna go one. There you go, he's gonna quick strike for two. Then die, give us two swords. Okay. So Joust is now gone. And that opens up really not too much for us. Then we go. We can't attack him because he's flying. He's gonna go here. He's gonna attack for three. And then retaliate a one. Okay. We're gonna pull the plank, killing him, giving us. I think it's no source when you pull the plank, if I'm correct. When you pull a plank, you have the captain strategic maneuver of the pull a plank fortress advancement. You defeat all units and all groups of units currently on the plank. Ship rewards only granted to an active unit defeated this way. After you pull the plank, place the plank beside the barracks. So four source there. And it's up to 13. That is the end of the wave. Alright guys, I am gonna need to take a break from this game. This is 2.5 hours of just roughness. I'm gonna go just watch, relax, chill with my wife. I do appreciate you guys watching. Once again, Board Game Italia, thanks so much for the follow, man. Yeah, I wish solo was more exciting than what it is. This game is just a very stressful game. If you didn't see my video and you got the expansions, you can see how it all goes fits in one box. But once again, thanks for watching, guys. We'll be back again next week. Well, not next week, we'll be back on Wednesday. All right, thanks so much, guys. Have a great Sunday. I might be back later tonight, but I doubt it.